Hi everyone, Cindy here. I am coming back to share the other items of my haul over the last probably 4 to 6 weeks. And these are more the laces, the fabrics, the other kind of things, books, stuff like that. So let's get started because this might be kind of a long video. So I'm going to go kind of quickly so it doesn't take so long. Okay, so I'm going to start with like the laces and trims and stuff. And the really big things that I'm really excited about, one of them is this. This is a really old spool of this beautiful trim. I was really lucky to get this. There were several others. I wasn't able to get to this estate sale until later. But this one was still there, which I'm surprised because it's a pretty pink color. So I was really excited. And the lady was telling me that this is really old because the lady who had it, she was like 90 some years old. And she said that this belonged to her mother or grandmother. I can't remember. I'm going to say mother. So if the lady was 90... then this is pretty old, so, and it's really in good shape too. There's a few dirty areas here, but other than that, it's in really good shape. So, there's that one, and then there was this beautiful trim that I got, and this is old. Actually, it's wrapped on the wrong way. Let's see if I can show you quickly. I need to move quickly. Anyways, so gorgeous. This is old. I loved it. I paid a little bit more for that. Not a ton, but a little bit more than I normally do. But I just loved it, so I had to get it. Okay. And then this stuff is just a bag of trims and stuff. And actually, there's some really neat pieces in here. Some crocheted pieces. And she must have just... did some, like, this is really neat. They're leaves, and there's a bunch there. And these are like little corner pieces, and there's two of them, and there's a bunch in there. There's some more leaves. Here's some little flowers, which are pretty. So I think this lady crocheted this stuff, so... I was pretty excited about that. There's some collars in here. This is like a collar. This, I think, is maybe off of a pillowcase, and I don't know if she did it or what, but... So those are neat. Here's a purple one. Let's see what else is here. And then just... those look kind of... could be a leaf, I suppose. So that's fun. Excited about that. And then there was this. I went to an estate sale. I was late getting to this one too, and I was surprised what was left. So all these laces, and I paid $5 for this, and yeah, there's some really pretty laces on here. So I couldn't believe these were here. And at this estate sale was, I also had purchased some nice Pyrex pieces, and this was in my previous video. I picked up that Pyrex promotional piece and some of that Corel ware. So I was excited about that. So I got that there, and I also got this other bag at that same sale. This one also. So this one is really pretty. I love this blue one. And this one, I think I only paid $4 for. Yeah, $4 for all this. There's a ton in here. There's some elastic. This one's really pretty. So, I won't pull it all out. It'll take me forever. So, that's a pretty good deal right there. $4. So, Okay, and then there was this I got at the thrift store, and I couldn't believe it was there. I was so excited. This is from my favorite thrift store. Look at how pretty that is. And there's quite a bit still on here. And this is the Ofray. I paid 96 cents for it, so pretty excited about that. And then this was there for Halloween, or for fall coming, I guess, and it's brand new. And that was 50 cents, so I like that. And then my other big score, I think, was this big bowl. I always see these. This is hand-carved, and they're usually really, really expensive. And I was able to get this, I think, at a reasonable price. So, pretty excited about that. Okay, moving on. Got some doilies and things. Good old stack. I think, you know, I can't remember exactly. I think I got this this was at a estate sale. I think this stuff was in a bag I got at the thrift store, I believe. And they're really cute, some of the smaller ones. This one's really pretty. And I think these are hand done. As well as that and this. But these right here are all store-bought. But even so, I'm okay with that. So these are all the round ones. I've washed them all already. And then these are some heart ones, which are really pretty. So, and there's a good pile of them. So that's cool. Excited about that. And then just, this is a piece. It's definitely falling apart, so I will be cutting that up. And just, that's a pretty piece. Just some more doilies. This is a really pretty one. I really like this one. It has the pink in there. And this is a bigger one, a round one. Oh, and then this is a blanket. Big old blanket. Well, I'm sorry, it's not a blanket, it's a tablecloth. And this is man-made, or machine-made. Sorry. This is machine-made. And it has a stain right here, but that's okay, because I don't really use that part. But I got it for $5, and it's pretty big. I couldn't resist that. And then these are some dresser runner things, which I thought were really pretty. And this is, I'm not sure what it is, maybe like a center table thing. Going to be kind of hard to show you, but it has this kind of work on it, and it has a seam down the middle, which is really weird. I think this was in like a package, like maybe with the doilies that I bought, because I didn't buy this individually. And then these are some pillow shams, and there's two of them, and I haven't decided if I'm going to use it or pull it apart. Haven't decided yet. That I won't know until I get done painting my house and doing all that fun stuff. So I will leave it intact until I get all my painting and redecorating done. So, okay. Next is this. This is some thrift store finds. I got really lucky. This thrift store just recently went out of business, so I was pretty bummed because I could usually find some pretty good things there, but I went out of business, so the exciting things are these things on top. I've kind of gone through, pulled them out. So there's the leaves, some of these old millinery flowers. I just love those. Some more pink ones. There's some really old leaf cream ones. Love those. Some pretty blue ones, some cream leaves like this, these. These are really pretty. So some of these rolled ribbon flowers, some black ones. Velvet, or these aren't velvet, no. But there are some velvet. Here's some velvet, black velvet ones. Oh yeah, the good stuff's on top there. So that's fun. I'll have to go through and, you know, see what I can use there. And then at that same thrift store, there was this bag too, which has more of the ribbon, sorry, not in frame, ribbon, rolled ribbon flowers. And they had some of these. I don't know if you guys remember these. These are fun. You had the shirts that were too big and you tied in your, you know, end tails in there. But I was thinking I could alter these. They had, there's actually quite a few in here. So I, you know, I can paint these and then, you know, put a piece of paper, a pretty piece of paper in the center and, you know, decorate it up. So I figured that's what I could do with those. This gold one. So, and there's a bunch of just ribbon roses down in there. So that's fun. That will be fun to use. Okay. We will move on to the one of my favorite things. Buttons. So, mind you, this isn't over a period of, oh, what did I say, 4 to 6 weeks or something like that. So, yeah. Okay, so, this I gotten at one estate sale, which is very exciting. I love my buttons. And there's a lot of good ones in here. The mother of pearl buttons and the older vintage, mostly. Look at those roller skates. How cute are those? And then this whole box right here of mother of pearl. Those are gorgeous. So excited about that bag. And I paid $8 for that. And that is actually a really good price for that, how full it is. And then I got this one at a different estate sale at a different time. I paid $3 for that. And there's some good ones in here. Some really old and good ones. So I haven't gone through it yet. So that's fun. And then the last estate sales I went to, this is what I picked up. And this was full. I was pretty excited about that. And in there also was, in this big one, were the all these spools. So those are cool. I always like my spools. This is pretty neat too. This is really old thing. Cotton. This one's really nice, old. So those are fun. Some vintage seam binding here and some bias tape, I think. And this is really some old, sorry, I'm not in frame, thread. So I have a basket and I just like to put all my old thread in there. I guess if that's what you call that. Embroidery thread, maybe? I don't know what you call it. But anyways, I have a basket with some, just some really old stuff, and I just love looking at it. So, and then there's this thing, and I haven't gone through it all yet. But there's some old stuff in here. Old mother of pearls, and there's a lot, some junk, and pins and stuff. Like this piece right here, that's old. Pretty. As well as this. This is good quality old stuff. So I like to put it. A lot of times I go to the thrift store, one of them that I go to around here, and, you know, I walk in and they have, you know, quite a few buttons or jars with buttons in them. And I start looking at them and they're all just old, not old, you know, shirt buttons, current shirt buttons. I think they maybe clip the buttons off of shirts, maybe, that don't sell, possibly, and put them in the jars and sell them, and they actually are kind of high priced, so I don't do that. So, but these are good old buttons. Here's a few samples of what are in there that I pulled out. This is gorgeous. I love this. Love it. And this is actually a pin. Love that. There's a couple of those that I found. It's this one I love. This is a very soft pink blush color. I did find a glass button, which I didn't look very hard, so I'm sure there's more in there. There's another glass and another pearl button, shell button. And look at how tiny these are. Oh my gosh, I just love these. I love them. I could just sit there and stare at buttons because I just love buttons. If you haven't figured that out by now. And these I got at the thrift store and I just thought they were adorable. Be really cute on a card or something. So, those are my buttons that I have found recently. Pretty excited. Okay. Move on to, hopefully you can hear me, moving on to like kind of the jewelry. I didn't really do much jewelry lately. I found these earrings, which are so cute. I love using these as flower centers. This I thought was a gorgeous piece. And this is a, I don't know what it is, actually. I was going to say it was a pin, but I don't know what it is. But isn't that pretty? I just think it's gorgeous. And I got a really good deal on that. And then I bought this bag of jewelry. Broken jewelry. And I only paid $3 for it. But it has some really good pieces in there. Let's see if I can pull out a couple of my favorites. Sorry, I should have had that done. Okay, here's one. Oh. That's worth $3 alone. And there's two of it's a pair. There it was earrings, but there's two of them. So I love those. There's this pretty green piece. There's that red piece. And then there's some little beads in here that I just thought were gorgeous. Look at those little beads. Look at these little pearl beads here. They have like little spikes or something on them. I don't know. So that's full. The bag is full with that stuff. So I thought it was well worth the $3 that I paid. Okay, and that's it for my jewelry. I did pick up these. You know, they're these little tarte or whatever things, but they are definitely well rusted, and that's what I liked about them. So those will be displayed somewhere in the room. And I like cards. I haven't altered them yet, but I really like the flowers and the colors on them. So, $1 for each package, which I thought that was a pretty good deal. Okay, so that is that. Okay, I'm going to move on to cards. If you've watched my previous video, I have gotten some vintage cards, a nice bunch of vintage cards, and again, I found some more. So, not as nice as that last bunch that I got, but these are still pretty good. These are still in package, which I thought were cute. These, you could definitely cut this off and use that. I thought it was cute. And I won't bore you with all of them. I've kind of got all the real good ones together. But I just love the old vintage cards. So this one I loved. There's a couple. That one's stained, but this one's in good shape. So some of these definitely older than others, but look at that. Isn't that cute? I love the colors. So there's a cute strawberry one. Okay. So, those are fun. And I paid, what did I pay? $2.50? $5 for all of this. And this isn't all of it, because I just pulled up the good stuff. These were adorable. They're a little note card, or note paper. And I love these images. And there were three of these in there. taken the other one out. So, and there's a few vintage cards in here. These were adorable, I thought. I love the colors. Look at that, an old like mason jar. And then there was this one too. Love the colors. Okay. So there's that one. And also the boxes. Like this is written on, but I love these images. And then I loved this one. Love this one. Unfortunately, there isn't any of these cards in here. But there, you know, were other good ones that I found. When I bought these, they have these little boxes. They're the half box, I guess, that a lot of times your soda comes in to hold them all together. Anyways, so they just fill it up with these boxes. And so I bought two of them. They were $2.50 each, I think. So isn't that cute? So I have got to start using some of my stuff. I love to shop, ladies. It's so much fun. You never know what you're going to find. But I have got to start using what I have. So those are all my envelopes. I kind of went through and organized. And those, I don't need to show you them. And these are, you know, I thought the box was cute. And the cards are cute, too. So those are those. So that is my card haul. Okay. All right, I'm going to move on to, I'm going to show you these. And then I'm going to move on to books. These are I love old wood crates and stuff. These are smaller ones. This is an old cigar box. And I love it. It is so worn. And I love look at that flower image on there. Gorgeous. So, didn't come with the lid, but that's okay. I still love it. This one, I loved this right here. It's an old crayon box, and it's Oklahoma City. That's where I live. So, I love this. I thought that was so cool. And I like to store some of my stamps in here. And I keep them out on my desk. This is one I had gotten a while ago. I don't know that I shared it. And this is just plain. But I love it. Look at that. I love that. And then there was this one. And I shared this one before. But I kind of have them all together. So there are my wood boxes. I love my wood boxes. Okay, I'm going to move on to books. Okay. I'm in frame? Okay. This isn't real old, but sadly, I have never read this story, Alice in Wonderland. So, I'm going to read this. I've seen the movies, the one out with Johnny Depp, but I have never read this story, and my daughter hasn't either, my oldest daughter. So we are going to read this book. I'm excited about that. I love chalkboards, old chalkboards, so I saw this at the thrift store. Had to pick it up. Okay, this is one of my great book finds. This is a Bible, and it is humongous, if you can see. And I'm not sure exactly of the date because the front page of it is gone. Well, it's here, but the part with the date is gone. But from what I've looked up on the internet and from what I've read inside, I believe it's from around, what did I say? The late 1800s to the early 1900s. There is a spot in here from who it belonged and the who gave it to her. Where is it at? Sorry, I want to move this out of the way. Let's see if I can find that page to show you because it's really neat. I should have had it marked. Sorry. Here it is. Okay.
This is so cool.
Don't want to open it all the way. I could break the spine. So let's turn you down. Okay. Here's a really old letter from... this is from the date right here. Can you see me? We're here in the corner. It says 1896. And the handwriting on this is just... Okay, this piece is broke off. I can bring it up. Look at that. I just love it. Look at that. 1896. That is so cool. I just love history like this. I'm a nerd. But, let's see if I'm in. Okay, so family record, and it has names and the date they were born. 1906 for this one is the earliest recording. But then you come over here, and it's, okay, her grandparents, or his grandparents. This is, I think, woman's handwriting. So, 1892 for her grandparents. I don't, it's just, so that's the earliest date, 1892. Granted, this book wasn't published then, but... late 1800s to the early 1900s, this book was published, I believe. And it's just awesome. I'm so excited about it. Love it. So, that was a big, big find for me. Just a moment. Okay, sorry about that. Okay, that's funny because... I just showed you an old Bible, and I just got a phone call from our church. My son had lost his Bible, and they found his Bible. Woohoo! So, that's funny. So, anyways, here is a dictionary that I found. I like old dictionaries. Don't know why, I just do. And this is from, I think it's a... Oh, no, it isn't. Okay, I thought it was from a... But it's not. I'm kind of talking to myself here. Sorry. Okay. And the date on this one is 1940. Yes. So, that's fun. Sometimes the images in these are great. So, and I just like old dictionaries because I'm weird. Okay. Moving on. I told myself I was not going to get any more books, but I went to an estate sale and it just didn't happen that way. Okay, so this is a little golden book, encyclopedia, and I just love the images, and they're just fun. And this is a Mother Goose. This isn't real, real old, but I have a Mother Goose book that I had when I was a kid, and I don't want to cut into it, so... This one I would cut into and use the images and stuff. I'm sorry, I'm not even in frame. So, this isn't real old. Okay. Okay. My kids love this Richard Scarry. And I do too. So, I got this book. Don't know that it's real old, but it's fun. Okay, this is old. This one's really old. Very cool. Not in the best shape, but I don't care. It's still old, and I love it. Let's see if I can get to the copyright date here, because I don't remember. 1919 is the copyright. How fun is that? 1919. Wow. Huh? So, and I paid 50 cents for this book. It's not in great shape, but in my book, that's a good deal. So, this is an old Pinocchio book. Excuse me. Which is fun. I like having these older books. This is an old Dr. Seuss. I didn't look at the year on this one. I'm not even familiar with this Dr. Seuss story, so... So that's fun. This is another fun one. Oh, wait, there's Peter Pan. That's fun. You know, these books are not in great shape, but I don't care. This one I really enjoyed. This is the Golden Book, Christmas book. And, oh, wow, look at that. I forgot that was in there. Look at that. Oh, my gosh. And it's still in great shape. Wow. Okay. Okay, this was given to somebody in 1947. Look at that. I love it. Let's see. There's a copyright. It's 1947, so love it. Love these images. I mean, I could just sit there. Oh, look at that. I just love that. And I would not cut this book up. I would, if I want to use an image, I would photocopy it and use it. And obviously, I don't sell my stuff, so, you know, that's okay, I think. So, my husband loves Charlie Brown, so I had to get this book, and so do my kids. It's written in, but I don't care. Okay. So, that's some. I mean, this lady had a ton of children's books. A ton. So, and I got a lot of them. But they were 50 cents. I mean, that's really good. You know, of the other children's books I've bought in the past, you know, I don't know that I've gotten them that good of a price. And this is the dictionary, which I love these dictionaries. I think I have one other like that. Here's another encyclopedia. So, and I love the images in these. So, Golden Book of Words. How fun are those images? Love. I mean, I would love to photocopy this and, you know, take a blow up at this picture and, you know, for my younger kids and say, okay, you need to brush your teeth, brush your hair in the mornings and stuff like that. So, fun, fun, fun. Okay, now I got a couple more of these. I had gotten some of these Ideals books, older ones, a while back. These are newer ones, so picked up those. I think I paid 10 cents. It says 91 cents, but I did not pay that. Okay. Not done with the books yet. Okay. I got another, I like the vintage scout books. So this is a Cub Scout book. It's fun. My son did Cub Scouts for a little while, but didn't continue. We have to wait on that. Not ready. This I got in a different estate sale, but this I love. Love, love, love. Look at how cool that. Practical sight word reading chart and phonic exercise. And what is the date on this? This is dated 1898. Oh, so cool. And look at this. Look at how cool. Oh, I just love this. I just think to myself, uh-oh, hang on. I gotta plug my camera in.